Many people have heard of typhoid fever, which is caused by a small number of Salmonella types, which are highly host adapted to cause an invasive disease in humans. Despite the fact that the first reports of a very severe form of invasive Salmonella disease associated with malaria was reported back in 1929, this has really been a very neglected disease. And in fact, results in death in more than one in four cases. So this severe form of invasive non-typhoid Salmonella disease is normally associated with other underlying conditions. Now, for these reasons, it was often assumed that classical types of Typhimurium, which normally cause diarrhoea, were in fact causing a more invasive and serious disease in these people because they were in a more vulnerable class. Our research, however, has shown that Typhimurium types which are causing invasive disease in some parts of Africa are actually really quite different from the classical types which are causing diarrhoea. This is really a new form of pathogen. So normally, non-typhoidal Salmonella only circulate within animal populations and are continuously introduced into humans where they cause diarrhoea by food poisoning. When we looked in more detail at the complete genome sequence, we found genetic signatures which suggested that this type of Typhimurium may be becoming more adapted to circulating within populations of humans. Treatment of invasive Salmonella disease in Africa has been confounded recently by the emergence of multi-drug resistance. During an 18-month period in Malawi, we went from a situation where virtually all isolates were susceptible to the frontline drugs to a situation where virtually 100% are resistant. These isolates became multi-drug resistant by the acquisition of a large block of genes encoding resistance to many different antimicrobials. So this work was very much dependent upon close collaboration with colleagues working out in the field. This allowed us to bring very important strain collections and samples together with high technology, high throughput sequencing. Tracking transmission pathways and the emergence of new pathogens can be most effectively done using next generation sequencing technologies. This allows us to see very small differences, single letter changes in the genome. The deeper we peer into the genomes of microbial pathogens, the more their incredible adaptability to exploit new host populations comes into sharp focus.